Hey guys, welcome to the Kids Corner. First, we'll hear from Mrs. Luann, and then we'll have a song.
Good morning, boys and girls of Gorman. Glad to talk to you this morning. Mr. David and I spent last week on a wonderful trip celebrating our 50th wedding anniversary, seeing all of God's beautiful work all over North Carolina, Virginia, and Tennessee. But we're back home now, and we're going to continue our talk about Nehemiah. If you remember last week, Nehemiah wanted to restore the wall around Jerusalem because it was ruined. It was just a mess. And he prayed about it, and he went to the king, and the king sent him on his way to do it. Well, Nehemiah had a lot of challenges ahead of him to get this wall done. There were two men, Sanballat and Tobiah, got these big names again, who were against Nehemiah doing that. They wanted to have control, and they didn't want him to have any success in building the wall. So he had to work around them. There was constant opposition. They were all the time trying to say, well, you can't do this and you can't do that. In many ways, they tried to trick Nehemiah. If you start in Nehemiah 2, chapter 2, verse 11 through chapter 6, 19. Now, that's a lot of reading in the Bible. But one thing that was really interesting, it gave the names of all the people who came together for this to happen. They're just names and names and names of people who all along the way worked with all their heart, and we're going to talk about that in a minute, to get the wall done. Well, first of all, Nehemiah had to sneak out in secret to examine the wall to see exactly what had to be done. Then when he came back, he had to really convince these people that this wall could be rebuilt. And he wanted them to work and have a plan, work side by side with all their heart. Then Nehemiah found out that there were people criticizing him, people trying to be sure that the wall didn't get built. And then there were even people trying to trick him and trying to attack the workers that were building the wall. But Nehemiah always prayed to get the guidance from God. So when it got tough, he had half the people working on the wall and half of the people guarding the wall. So all along the way, he had a plan. He put God's plan into play, building the wall. Then there were all kinds of other things that happened. They tried to get the people inside the wall upset. There were debts that these people needed to pay off. And Nehemiah had to get involved in that so that his workers could continue to work. But Nehemiah faced every one of these challenges in getting this wall head on. He just went and got it done, but not by himself. He depended on God. And each one of these challenges, he depended on God in each challenge. You know what? That wall was completed in 52 days. 52 days this wall was done. This is what happens when we depend on God for our plan. Remember last week our verse said he had a plan and a future for us? Well, Nehemiah depended on him and he got that wall built. All of the workers came together because he prayed for guidance and he prayed hard and it got done. I think this is a fascinating, fascinating story about getting this wall done. It has so many lessons for us. We're facing a lot of challenges this year in our country. You're going to have the challenge of starting school probably online this week or next week, or maybe it was last week. A challenge to get that schoolwork done in a whole different way. And you know what? If we pray about it and we give it to God, just like he had Nehemiah's plan come together, you'll be able to get it done. Well, this verse today, your key verse, is another verse that is so close to my heart. This has been 3 weeks that these verses have been my verses. Colossians 3:23 says, whatever you do, work at it with all your heart, as working for the Lord and not for men. Colossians 3:23. I'll tell you real quickly why that verse means something to me. In my job one time, there was a lot of stuff that went on, a lot of challenges, and I kind of got put over to do a job that I didn't want to do. it was a really yucky job. And I wanted to cry and I wanted to just walk away. But I called my sister and I wasn't upset. And I said, I don't know what to do. Maybe I should just quit. She said, read Colossians 3:23 and remember that whatever you're doing it, do it with all your heart. Do it like you're doing it for the Lord and meet that challenge. And you know what? I sat there and did that yucky job. I got it done and I just kept thinking, whatever you do, do it with all your heart for the Lord. And the Lord worked out, and within a few months I had the best job ever, and I still have it. So this verse is special to me too. Three verses special to me. Wow, this is just getting to be something, isn't it? Well, I love this story. It teaches us that we can depend on God for every challenge. And I know the challenges are coming at us, but you know what, kids of Gorman? God's got it if we'll just give it to Him. Love y'all. See you next time.
Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working.
tune into our morning worship service with music and Pastor Craig preaching.